I hope most of friends from meeting are now acquainted with the developments in Jammu and Kashmir. And but I still have doubts whether the wider sections of our people in the whole of the country, I mean, are not sufficiently informed about the developments which have taken place on 5th of August 2019 and the condition of the situation which is prevailing in Jammu and Kashmir, particularly in the valley itself, on account of that political, I put it an assault on constitution itself, what happened on that day in the Parliament of India regarding Jammu and Kashmir. People of the country have been misled by the dominant force, particularly the government itself, about the necessity of doing what they have done on 5th of August. As a concerned citizen, I have a firm belief and fact support that belief. That was not just the question of depriving the people of Jammu and Kashmir from their basic rights, constitutional rights. Of course, that is one aspect, but fundamentally, that was the beginning of a process of undermining the constitution of India, not only vis-a-vis the constitutional provisions of Kashmir, concerned with Kashmir, but as we are witnessing now, since then, there have been series of legislations which in my view, our view, is the continuation of that process which was unfortunately started in the Parliament of India on 5th August 2019. Now what exactly has happened on that particular day? If you go through the very, very legal procedure which was followed by the government of India to abrogate the provisions of the Constitution of India, I emphasize this, the provisions of the Constitution of India, that is Article 370, and related issues. Abrogation has taken place, undermining the constitution itself, assaulting the basic structure of the constitution of India. Besides that, in our view, that has proved to be, that is virtually a very big setback to the very foundations of the unity between the people of Jammu and Kashmir and the rest of the country. Please try to, my appeal to countrymen is, have a larger picture in mind while dating the that event which has been initiated in the Parliament arbitrarily by BJP government. And I have been talking since then, whenever I got an opportunity, mostly with the Supreme Court intervention to avail the opportunity for medical treatment at Delhi AIIMS. I have been talking that this is not to be seen in isolation. I had appealed to the countrymen, as a citizen of this country, appealed every section of the society that this is not to be seen in isolation. This is not just removing certain obstructions so-called in the process of integration as claimed by those who are at the helm of affairs. It is not. It is contrary to that, dear colleagues. What is the truth? I appeal to the countrymen through you, through many more friends who may be informed through you, that the country must be taken into confidence, must be told the exact picture. And Kashmir, Jammu and Kashmir should not be seen in today's context alone. Jammu and Kashmir's history of being part of this country starts when the region got independence from foreigners, Britishers, and unfortunately followed by unhistoric, unwarranted partition of the country. I'm not going through the pages of the history now, not to overburden your viewers. But fundamentally, I must tell you, when division took place, the then Maharaja was reluctant for some time to accede to India, to join India. He had, in fact, entered into one agreement, standstill agreement with Pakistan, and he was aspiring for an independent Jammu and Kashmir, directly or indirectly supported by the very elements who are claiming to be hyper-nationalistic, super-nationalists. These are the facts of the history. And that's why the first agitation which was initiated by the very forces who are now in control of the country, that initiated the agitation in Jammu itself, from Jammu and Kashmir, under the cover of full integration with the Union of India. What was the situation at that time? Maharaja acceded only when the raiders from the other side came. Asking for army assistance, military assistance from the Union of India, he signed the instrument of accession. And virtually, that instrument of accession was accompanied by another letter which was conditional, making the relationship between Union and Jammu and Kashmir not on the same lines as the rest of the states did. This is number one. The second thing is, when there was a competitive claim from the other side of the border, the then border, Pakistan, I mean, it was the will of the people of Jammu and Kashmir. It was the will of the movement led by Sheikh Mohammed Abdullah, which facilitated the process of accession with the Union with certain guarantees provided by the Constituent Assembly of India. None else but the highest forum of the country, not the parliament, but the Constituent Assembly of India. It is how Article 370 emerged out of discussions and out of debate in the Constituent Assembly of India. And again, there was a long process of negotiations between the leadership of India, the founders of the Constitution of India, and the leadership of Jammu and Kashmir. It took 5 months. That is how the decision to convene a separate constituent assembly of Jammu and Kashmir emerged, was decided. That's how this out of this process, this decision emerged. Please try to understand what they did on 5th of August. They not only dismantled the constitutional provisions, not only it is unconstitutional, but keeping in view the facts, the truth is that the very basic structure of federal structure of our constitution has been attacked and severely damaged. So that's why I suggest it's not just an attack on the people of Jammu and Kashmir. It is the beginning of a process virtually to impose authoritarian regime, full-fledged authoritarian regime in the whole of the country. Virtually attacking the very basic federal structure of the country. It is an assault on the question of the relationship between the union and the states as a whole. Now what has happened then? I again remind my countrymen, there were certain writ petitions pending in Honorable Supreme Court challenging Article 370 and the provisions of that article, Article 335A. And there were certain intervention applications. I was one of the applicants who had moved a petition in the Supreme Court for intervention in support of retaining Article 370 and 35A. One simple question is here. Mr. Prime Minister, Mr. Home Minister, as a citizen I am questioning you, what prompted you to not waiting for the Supreme Court decision regarding these very petitions? Please try to understand. The Supreme Court is an institution, constitutional institution. Certain petitions regarding the same subject are pending. What are the circumstances which forced you to initiate a process of constitutional coup? I put it constitutional coup with huge disrespect to the parliament itself, with huge disrespect to the provisions of the constitution, and with huge disrespect to the Honorable Supreme Court as well. Now, this is one aspect. Another aspect is, you might not be knowing, my countrymen might not be knowing, in many of the places where states have been divided, like Andhra, Telangana has emerged out of what? Protracted discussions, debates in parliament, in assembly, on streets, in different forums. People have got involved and provided the feedback, expressed their views. When UP got divided, Bihar got divided, the same process was adopted. But here's a state called Jammu and Kashmir, who was taken into confidence. Governor, a person who is the nominee of the government of India itself, he does not represent any section of the population in Jammu and Kashmir. I hope you agree with me. Governor is governor everywhere. Governor is not the choice of the concerned people of that particular state. Governor is always being imposed by the union itself. Then our question is, such a major decision, removing constitutional provision, dismantling the constitution of Jammu and Kashmir. People do not know here. We were having a separate constitution, which was the constitutional provisions of Constitution of India provided that process which enabled the people of Jammu and Kashmir to have their own constituent assembly, thereby adoption of a separate constitution as well. That constitution has been dismantled. That constitution again has emerged, not in assembly, but again in a constituent assembly of Jammu and Kashmir. Again, the union government and the then assembly and the parliament and all that, they approved of it. Have you ever seen happening such a thing in the midnight? Nights are black and they are considered to be reserved for something which are not done in the daylight. I'm not unsure about it. Even the BJP members who thumped the desks there on that particular day, they obediently worked, applied, without applying the mind, I hope, and with an avance together, Article 370, 35A, and the Constitution of Jammu and Kashmir, the flag of Jammu and Kashmir, and not only that, a state with its unique history and culture, having a long history is downgraded to the level of union territory. I put it in the court of the countrymen. Judge it. Don't you feel if such an act is happening elsewhere, don't you feel the population will feel humiliated? Don't you feel that the population of Jammu and Kashmir has been pushed to the wall? Now, since then, Honorable Home Minister is saying us that there is normalcy. I wish you should visit Kashmir and you will see with your own eyes whatever democratic rights, civil liberty rights are guaranteed by the Constitution of India are provided in Kerala and elsewhere maybe. People of Jammu and Kashmir have been deprived of all those basic civil liberty rights on the whole. It is like a big prison. Nothing short of that. Political leaders under detention, some of them even not knowing the reasons of their custody. And no political activity
from any other political party except the one which is ruling the country. Nobody else. They are inviting selected parliamentarians from the European Union. They might be inviting the envoys from different countries, but they are afraid of allowing senior leaders of the country and the members of the parliament to interact with the people of Kashmir. They don't allow them. CPIM General Secretary came. Twice he was not allowed to meet me. Third time, it is because of Honorable Supreme Court direction, intervention, that he could meet me with certain specific direction, not to move around. Is this the protection of our way of protecting the democratic rights of the people of Kashmir? I'm asking the government of India. Now what is today? Even recently, I can just request our esteemed friends in the country to look into this. Nowhere in the world communication has been not stopped. Virtually the whole thing is disbanded. Very late, after some months, we were provided the facility of using postpaid mobiles. Now recently there were certain petitions in Honorable Supreme Court, and the judgment came that internet facility, the communication, so facilities so provided, if denial of those is virtually an attack on fundamental rights. Kerala High Court did it. And then recently Supreme Court of India said, asked the Jammu and Kashmir government and asked the Union government, they have recently issued an order. That order is, I don't know. Use the net services in the essential services departments like hospitals. It's not a service for the patient, no. Because patient can talk to the doctor in Delhi. And doctor here in Delhi or somewhere can communicate their advice to the concerned patient. That facility is not available even now after this Supreme Court decision. Now a person who wants to go for higher studies, he has to seek guidance by using the net services. He is denied of that opportunity. There is no entertainment facility available. The only entertainment is huge presence of police force on the ground. And today, if this facility is denied here in Kerala, think it for a while. How will you react? How will our friends in other streams react? Now what about the media person? Now the Kashmir press has become virtually the official gazette. They don't have independent access to the information, to get information from in Kashmir or outside. It is miserable. It is horrible. But only one thing now, things are coming, that there is a huge now announcement, 63 ministers are visiting after 5 months, 63.
Not a joke.
You can well imagine the strength of our this back, how much we can accept and tolerate. 63 is a huge body count. 63 out 36, no, not 63, 36. I'm sorry. Out of 36, 31 for Jammu. And only 5 for Kashmir and none for Ladakh. Doing what? There is a harsh winter. A few months before, there was a huge calamity of snowfall and one of the major streams of economy, that is fruit industry, apple industry. Not only the fruit has been destroyed, but the fruit trees got destroyed. A team of senior leaders of Kisan movement, one from Kerala as well, Mr. Krishna Prasad was accompanying them. There were others as well. They visited, they have seen. Their estimation is it is thousands of crores. It's not only apple, but the trees as well. Not even a junior officer or junior minister from Delhi has visited to assess the loss. Just to talk to some section. Our business is totally where there is no detentions, no public transport available. You can well understand the state of business, not only in Kashmir but Jammu as well. Talk to Jammu Chamber, talk to Kashmir Chamber, they will tell you what the reality is on the ground. My only suggestion, my only request, my only appeal to the government of India is, if you don't have anything to offer, don't spread lies about your doing this in Jammu and Kashmir. Please, don't do it. Now one more thing, another unfortunate thing, only one or two days before has happened, that, you know, people in uniform, we expect them to work whatever the task is assigned lawfully, and they are doing their job. But sometimes, some of them at the helm of affairs, like General Rawat, who has been given bigger assignment, is used to make comments which create more uncertainty, add to the uncertainty. Should have been avoided. Now, what was the necessity of talking in some seminar held in Delhi, organized by Foreign Affairs Ministry and some NGO? Was there any necessity of making a comment? Now, radicalization is increasing in Kashmir. General Sahab, radicalization, communalization is increasing not only in Kashmir, but now being promoted, encouraged in the whole of the country by those who claim to be defenders of the Constitution of India. Now, what is radicalization? What is out of radicalization, emergence of extremism mean? This is not born somewhere. Look towards Kashmir, it was Kashmir when whole country got partitioned, when there was bloodbath on both sides of the border, it was only Kashmir where not a single incident took place. It's not me saying now, it is that great person who is again not being acceptable to those who are said to be protectors of whatever he has achieved for the people of India. Gandhiji, he said it. I want to remake the rest of the country in the image of Kashmir. Then, when there was bloodbath on the both sides of Punjab and elsewhere as well, where unfortunately bhai bhai ka dushman ban gaya, a neighbor was not a neighbor but they became enemies. Even in Jammu, but it was Kashmir. Now I want to remind General Saab, it was Kashmir. Despite political uncertainties, it was Kashmir where most of the people, even in nights, tourists, they never felt insecure. Ask the elders, those who have visited Kashmir in those days, they will tell you the stories. Now the classic with the leadership of the country should have been not to deepen the disappointments, not to deepen the disillusionment, but to provide confidence building, to initiate confidence building measures to own the people of Kashmir. This is the only tested method of fighting radicalism, fighting extremism. Yes, later. I will just, I don't think this is a mandate for anybody in uniform. And now he has mentioned, this is already going on segregation. They're putting even children from 10 to 12 in camps. He has mentioned even the number in his statement. We urge upon the government of India, it has created a lot of unrest again in the minds of the youngsters in Kashmir. Please come open. Please tell the facts to the country as a whole. Who are these people? 400, 300, whatever the number General Sahab has said, where are they placed? This is the least which we are expecting from today's leadership of the country. And finally, I cannot but greet the people of Kerala in general and primarily the legislature of Kerala, which has stood up in support of the constitution itself, which has taken a bold initiative and set a message that still there is a hope for functional democracy in India. Thank you very much. I have taken enough of your time. I am sorry for that. Well, I have come from a long distance, isn't it?
Yeah. After lifting the ban on internet, what's the current situation? After lifting of internet ban?
That is not. That's what exactly I am telling you. You see, what they have made a review after the Supreme Court decision. Now they have said that we will provide certain facilities like hospital, like the offices of essential services, not to the common citizen. This is what my point of view is. And they have promised us now tentative commitment. The other aspects will be taken reviewed after 26th of January, Republican Day. Again, tentative. My appeal to the people of the rest of the country is, all the people, all their sufferings as well, please raise your voice. Raise your voice against the injustices meted out to the unfortunate people of Jammu and Kashmir. And at least raise your voice for restoration of democratic rights, civil liberty rights, and communication networks which have been virtually disbanded.
Comrade, we read a news that Omar Abdullah and his father is going to London.
To?
London.
They are not gone yet. They are under detention sitter. So these are rumors and all that. I am supposed not to indulge in promoting the systematic process of rumors emerging from the power centers.
The government, saying that if they go to
I have not seen such conversation going on. I have not seen such orders. That's why I thought this prime minister have the courage to lift the restriction, release the political leaders, release those youngsters who have been put outside in jails outside the state. Remove the harsh treatment which you have, which is the only option you have left for the people of Kashmir. This is extremely unfortunate, and I worry. Silence, as Arundhati Roy has said, proves to be bigger in sound someday. My point is, silence is not acceptance. So, what we demand is, we demand at least the same rights as the people in rest of the country are supposed to enjoy. I don't know, we have seen what has happened recently in Jamia. We have seen what has happened in Jain. We have seen what has happened in UP. That's why I said, whatever has been initiated in Kashmir, it's the beginning of a bigger, bigger process of uncertainty. The trend needs to be arrested, and nobody can do it except the collective, united will of the people of India. And Kerala has shown the path how you can work together. You may have differences, but you can work together as well, at least on certain issues which concern the future of the country, future of the constitution, and future of the people. Thank you very much.
Kerala also, government is trying to control the government. Governor, Kerala government is trying to control the government.
Unlike others here, the Kerala government, Mr. Arif Mohammed Khan, is constantly attacking the left government in approach the Supreme Court against CAA. And
you see, that is how what Arif Khan means. This is what the governors do in those harsh times. They have virtually, what has governor done in Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, quite recently? Why are you blaming him? Governor Ani, what did Prime Minister, Home Minister, and President of India? In the midnight, everything was moving. So my point is,
so he deployed to do that. Are you saying that he deployed for doing that?
Who?
Governor.
No, he may be part of it. He may be part of it. You see, as of now, when I say democracy is under attack, that means the nominees of the government of India are part of that process of ignoring or eroding the very fundamentals of the Constitution of India. Many of them. I am not saying here only. Here it is more open. I agree with you. But surely, I have a hope. I, as a person, have a hope that the country is bigger than the size of those who claim to be something more than the Constitution. They are bigger in underestimating the people. They are bigger. They are bigger in spreading untruths, falsehoods. But
there's a bigger voices emerging in the country from each side to protect the product of the long struggle of freedom. That is, the product is the Constitution itself. Constitution is a guide now for every individual. Young boys from universities are coming out in defense of the Constitution. Now look, women, they are on the street since days, not demanding anything, not demanding any mercy, demanding only the right to live as citizens, demanding the defense of Constitution of India. I am so happy that the pulse of the people is telling us that the coming future will be ours. Ours, I mean, the people of India. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
So, you, just before you told that you don't worry about the people in Kashmir, that the things happening in Kashmir. Sir, what about the Kashmiri Pandit? Did you take any action to get them back to your Kashmir?
I must tell you very frankly, to be Kashmiri Pandits are tragedies. The happenings, that's part of the bigger tragedy. I was the first political being who was attacked by some extremist elements and forced to migrate to Germany in 89. I did not want it. That's not my subject, because you have mentioned about those who were forced by the circumstances to leave their home and heart, that's Kashmiri Pandit, along with others. People like me, I know their pain. I know their, I share their suffering. I have a lot of respect for them. I will be observing my ear the day when I see them returning to their homes with full sense of security and dignity. That will be a bigger year for me. Thank you very much.